Welcome to Fix It Home Improvement, covering projects that every homeowner should know and great products for home and garden.
Hi, I'm JC, and this is where we share weekly home improvement tips. I'm here with my co-host, Cindy.
Hello, JC.
Hi, Cindy. This week, we're going to be talking about shower doors, and we got another five-star rating on Apple Podcasts. They didn't leave a name, but we appreciate it. Book 12 is at the editor, and we'll let you know when you can download a copy from Amazon. In the 1920s, some bathtubs had a shower option. It was usually just a pipe that extended up from the faucet, and the tub would have a circular shower rod over the center of the tub. The Sears catalog was selling shower kits in the 1920s. The U.S. Census Bureau did a survey in 1940, and only 55% of U.S. homes, they estimated, had a tub or a shower. 45% of U.S. homes didn't have indoor plumbing.
Wow.
Crazy, huh? 1940. One of the first companies to make glass shower doors started in the 1960s, and some of the first frameless shower doors came out in the 1970s.
Wow.
This week, we'll talk about some of the standard shower and tub doors that you can pick up from a home center or a supply house and install yourself. If you have a custom shower or a unique design, there are custom glass companies that will build shower doors and panels to fit.
Hmm.
For bathtubs, the most common type of door is a sliding door, but you can get a pivot or fixed. With showers, the most common doors are pivot and sliding, but you could also get bifold or fixed. A pivoting shower door swings open on some type of hinge, and the hinges can be attached to a wall, a surround, or a stationary glass panel. Pivoting shower doors work well in narrow shower stalls, and you can combine a pivoting door with a fixed glass panel for a wide stall. Check that there's room for the door to swing. Some door kits allow you to have the door open to the right or the left, and some can be mounted to open in or out. The building code says hinge shower doors must open outwards, not just inward.
Why?
So the reasoning is if someone falls in the shower and blocks the door, it might be difficult to get them help. Sliding doors usually have two sliding doors that overlap when they're closed, and these work well on wide showers or over a tub. For very wide showers, you can have additional fixed glass panels, and these are also good for smaller bathrooms where there's not room for a pivoting door.
Mm-hmm.
The doors are going to slide on a track or on an exposed rod, like a barn door style closet door. And with the barn door style, one of the doors is usually fixed. So with this style, you need to check which side is fixed because you want the doors to overlap so water coming out of the shower head hits the door that's overlapping on the inside of the shower, and that's going to prevent water from spraying through the opening between the doors. And you also don't want to enter or leave the sliding door next to the toilet or the sink, let's say if that's how it's positioned.
Mm-hmm.
You may not want this style, or you might want a different style so you can enter and leave the shower, you know, away from a toilet or a sink or some other fixed object. Did I explain that well?
Yeah.
Bifold and trifold doors slide and pivot like closet doors. They're not swinging into the bathroom, so they work well if you don't have a lot of space. Fixed shower doors are generally a solid pane of glass that doesn't move. So you have this open space to enter and exit, usually for showers, but I've seen a couple styles for bathtubs. Fixed shower doors work well with barrier-free showers that have a low or no curb, so it's easy for people with limited mobility or if you're setting up a home for an older family member.
Mm-hmm.
Shower doors have three frame types: framed, semi-frameless, and frameless. The frame shower doors have a metal or composite frame around all the glass panels, and you can match the color or finish to your fixtures. You can get them in brushed nickel, chrome, brass, and bronze. Framed shower doors are going to cost less than frameless, and because you have a frame to support the glass can be thinner. Generally, framed doors are easier to install and adjust, and they work well for wide openings.
Hmm.
Semi-frameless doors have a frame around the shower door or doors, but the door itself usually won't have a frame on the top or the handle side of the door. And some of the semi-frameless sliding doors will have a frame on the top and the bottom and the sides, but the doors themselves won't have a frame around the glass. So the doors will have hardware on top to roll and a handle. But companies have different definitions of what they call semi-frameless. In general, you're going to have less metal or composite around the door or the doors.
Okay.
A frameless shower door is made out of thicker, heavier glass, usually 3/8 to a 1/2 inch thick. And depending on the type of door, you're going to have very little or no frame. It's a very modern, high-end look. If you have a hinged frameless shower door that's above a tiled floor with no curb, the door itself may only have hinges on one side and a handle. So they're putting holes in the glass for the handle or towel bars, and that's how they're attached. There's really nothing else metal on it or composite. Frameless sliding doors will have a rail or a rod above the door and no frame around the glass. For doors with stationary panels, the fixed panel will have a thin frame on one side and the bottom, or they might be held in place with just clips or small brackets. But with frameless, there's very little metal. You just see a lot of glass. I've put in framed and semi-frameless doors in quite a few showers.
How'd that go?
Good, good. And they really add a nice look, especially in some of these older homes. With the frame doors, though, especially on the bottom, mineral deposits, soap, mold, and dirt from the water will build up over time, and it's going to be more difficult to keep clean compared to semi-frameless or frameless doors, where there's nothing to trap the water.
Right.
You can still get a buildup of soap and mineral deposits on frameless doors if you don't have a good cleaning routine, but frameless is going to be easier to keep clean.
Okay.
When you're comparing shower doors, you can get clear, frosted, tinted, or patterned panels. Clear glass shower doors are great if you have decorative tile, wall panels, or fixtures that you want to show off. And with smaller bathrooms, it's going to make them feel larger with the doors closed compared to like frosted panels. Makes the room feel smaller. The shower is going to be much brighter when you're using it. Some clear glass will have a greenish tint. So if because there's iron in it. And if you don't want that green tint, you can get low iron glass panels. Some companies call it HD glass. You can get tinted glass in multiple colors. It's going to give a unique look to your bathroom. You can get a color to complement your wall paint or your fixtures. You can get
change colors.
You can't.
Ever?
You can get light shades of blue, gray, or beige, or you can go with darker colors like gray or bronze. Frosted glass allows light into the shower, but it gives you some privacy. And there are a lot of different varieties, so some are more see-through than others. I read a couple articles from decorators, and they said that they found that frosted shower doors didn't look as clean as clear glass. But with clear glass, you have to have a good maintenance routine to keep it looking good.
Makes sense.
Rain glass is similar to frosted glass. It's going to give you privacy, and this has a distinctive decorative raindrop pattern on the outside of the glass. It's going to be smooth on the inside, so it's easy to clean. And this is the style I put in a few homes. I think it's more interesting than just frosted. You can get hammered glass, and this has a decorative texture that looks like small indentations in the glass. And depending on your lighting, it can pick up the light and be very reflective.
Exciting.
Patterned glass comes in a variety of designs. You can get subtle shapes of tree limbs or flowers. You can get a pattern of squares or circles in different colors or tints. It can be the focal point of your bathroom. And a couple of decorators said these work best in large bathrooms.
Okay.
It can be overpowering in a small bathroom. Mm-hmm. Shower doors are made out of safety glass, either tempered or laminated. Laminated glass is two layers of glass that's held together with a clear plastic between them that's baked into the glass. So if the glass ever breaks, the plastic holds the pieces together, so you have less of a chance of getting cut. And these are primarily used in a framed shower door. Tempered glass is about 4 times stronger than ordinary glass, and if it breaks, it fractures into small chunks that are less likely to cause an injury, but you can still get cut with tempered glass.
Right.
And these are used in framed and frameless shower doors. The Kohler Company says to help prevent shower doors from breaking, make sure that the moving panels are securely attached to the door system and routinely check the hardware that it's tight and secure. You should make sure that the moving panels don't come in contact with metal parts. Add bumpers where needed if it's coming in contact with the wall or the frame. If there's any chips or cracks, you need to replace the panel immediately. The glass can potentially shatter into thousands of pieces. They say never use the handle or towel bars on shower doors as safety grab bars or support for your weight. It can cause the glass to explode.
Not good.
Wild, huh? A report by ABC News said one of the biggest problems with tempered glass shower panels is damaging the edge of the glass, or if there's impact to the edge of the doors, it can cause the panels to shatter. 3M and Gila, it's G-I-L-A, they have clear safety film that you can put over shower doors and panels, and this will hold all of the pieces together if the glass were to ever break. And a lot of hotels now are using safety film on their shower doors.
Right.
So if you have kids or older family members that could lose balance and potentially grab hold of a shower bar on the door or the handle and cause it to explode, even though safety glass breaks into very small, kind of rounded pieces,
right,
it can cut you. And some of these heavy...
Is it still glass?
Yeah. And some of them, like the half-inch thick glass, a sheet of this is very heavy. And if it comes collapsing down on you, it can, you know, do a lot of damage potentially. I spoke to Signature Hardware, and they're at signaturehardware.com. They carry shower doors, and they had some tips. They say when you're ordering pre-made shower doors, measure the width at the top, the middle, and the bottom of the shower door opening, and use the largest of the three measurements as your shower door width.
Even if over a tub?
Right, yeah, whatever the opening is. So, like, if you have an alcove shower or an alcove tub, so you have three walls and one opening to get in and out, you're going to take three measurements. The largest measurement is what you'll use, and they said you need to be very exact. Measure to the nearest 16th of an inch. For a shower tub, measure the distance from the top rim of the tub or the shower pan or the floor, if you don't have a base, to the height that you want. The standard shower door is between 70 to 76 inches tall, and you want to match the height of the top of a surround or the top of the tile, depending on how your shower tub is set up. If you're tall and want a framed or semi-frameless shower door, look for models that are taller. I've seen some up to 82 inches tall. Or if you're very tall and you don't want to worry about a frame or ducking, you can go with frameless pivoting or a fixed panel door.
Interesting.
If you want a pivoting shower door, measure the distance to fixtures to make sure you have the room for that style. And check out some of the glass coating options. Some manufacturers now have coatings on their shower doors and panels that will help prevent soap and minerals from sticking. And some of these also resist the growth of mold. If you want to clean your shower door, a couple of top-rated non-toxic cleaners come from Puracy. It's P-U-R-A-C-Y. They have a plant-based cleaner that's non-toxic, and 7th Generation has plant-based cleaners. A couple of top-rated shower door cleaners are from Trinova, it's T-R-I-N-O-V-A, and Rainix, R-A-I-N-X. Some top-rated shower door companies, Kohler, Delta, Dreamline, American Standard, Vigo, V-I-G-O, and Sterling.
Do you have anything else to add?
If shower doors just seem like a lot of work and you just want to put up a shower curtain, I saw some interesting shower curtains at fineartamerica.com. They have historical shower curtains. You can get historic paintings, portraits of famous people like Einstein. You can have antique maps, the history of flight, and for Chicagoans, you can get a shower curtain with Mrs. O'Leary's cow on it.
Let's wrap this up.
You can subscribe to our podcast on Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, CastBox, or your favorite podcast app.
If you enjoyed it, please leave us a review.
You can check out our home improvement videos on our YouTube channel, Fix It Home Improvement.
And you can subscribe to that as well.
You can download our ebooks, Home Improvement Solutions, What Every Homeowner Should Know, Books 1 through 11, soon Book 12 on Amazon.
If you enjoyed it, please give us a 5-star rating and review.
You can email us at fixitpodcast@gmail.com. You can follow us on Instagram, Fixit Home Improvement, and you can follow us on Twitter, @fixitpodcast.
Thank you for listening.
Talk to you next week. Dip it, 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 dip it